हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर मंगेश दुशिंग एंड दिस इज़ द थर्ड वीडियो ऑफ यूवी स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड इन यूवी स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी एज वेल एज व्हाट इज़ द इफेक्ट ऑफ कॉन्जुगेशन ऑन द एब्जॉर्प्शन एंड एब्जॉर्बेंस। सो वील सी स्टार्ट विद द टर्म्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड इन यूवी स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। सो फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म इज क्रोमोफोर, दैट इज कलर बियरर। सो इट इज़ द आइसोलेटेड फंक्शन ग्रुप capable of absorbing UV radiations, that is near UV radiations, which called these groups as a chromophores. Greek word that is chroma, that is for the color, and phores, that is for the bearing. Though these type of functional group are independently absorbs the radiations in UV spectroscopy and gives a color. So this type of compounds, this type of groups are called as chromophores. So those are nitro groups, nitroso group, azo group, carbonyl group, cyano group, then imine group, carbon-carbon double bond, carbon-carbon S. So these are the functional group, unsaturated functional group. These functional group are independently capable to absorb the UV radiations and gives the colors to the that compound in UV visible spectroscopy. That's why this functional groups are called as chromophores, that is color bearers. Next term is auxochrome. So these are the color increaser, auxochrome. So this is the functional group which itself does not absorb any radiations in a near UV region, but when attached to the chromophore, that shifts the absorption to the longer wavelength. And some of the auxochromes are like OH, OCH3, NH and etc. So these are the functional group, themselves doesn't absorb the radiations in near UV region. But if these auxochromes are attached to the some chromophores, then it shifts the absorption towards the longer wavelength. Lambda max will be increased. So those groups are like OH, OCH3 or NH. So these groups are not absorbing the radiations in near UV, but they increases the lambda max, the absorption of chromophore. For example, suppose this is benzene, a chromophore which contains 6 pi electrons, so that absorbs at 255 nanometer. So this is a chromophore, so that absorbs radiations, UV radiations independently. If that benzene is substituted with OH or OCH3, independently OH or OH3 not capable to absorb the radiations, but if they attach to this benzene, then that becomes phenol. So lambda max is increased from 255 to 270 nanometer. Similarly, if we are using a OCH3, substituted the one of the hydrogen of the benzene, then the anisole will be there and that absorbs the radiations is around 260 nanometer. That's why this OH or OCH3 groups are called as auxochromes. Independently, those are not absorbing the radiations in near UV, but if they attach to the chromophore, that increases the wavelength of the absorption. So those groups are called as auxochromes, that is called as color increaser. The next term is bathochromic shift, so that is called as red shift. An absorption towards the longer wavelength is known as bathochromic shift or red shift. So just a previous example, we have seen that benzene is converted to the phenol, so absorption is shifted from lower wavelength, that is 255, to higher wavelength, that is 270. So this type of shift is called as bathochromic shift. So an absorption towards the longer wavelength, so higher lambda max, is known as bathochromic shift or red shift. So for example, this is the paranitrophenol. So this paranitrophenol lambda max is 255 nanometer and epsilon, that is molar absorptivity, is 900. So it absorbs at 255 nanometer. It's because of there is a longer resonance between this OH. OH has a plus R effect. So it donates its electrons to the benzene ring, and nitro group has minus R effect. So this getting this pi electrons on this oxygen. So because of this longer resonance, it absorbs at 255 nanometer. But if you put this nitrophenol in alkaline condition, then what will happen? Whatever this acidic proton of this phenol group, that will abstracted and phenoxide ion will form. that is nitrophen oxide. Now nitrophen oxide having this extra charge, that is negative charge, extra electrons, those electrons showing plus R effect similarly, and this electrons goes to the oxygen. But the electron donation capacity of neutral OH is less than the negatively charged oxygen. So what will happen? This resonance will be stronger, while this resonance will be weak. If this resonance is stronger, then it absorbs at longer wavelength, that is 265. So the wavelength previously was 255 nanometer is shifted to the longer wavelength, that is 265. Previously it was 255 nanometer, that shifts towards the 265 nanometer. That shifting towards the longer wavelength, absorption shifting towards the longer wavelength, is called as bathochromic shift or red shift. The electron donating resonance effect of negatively charged oxygen is more than the lone pair of oxygen. That's why the absorption shifted towards the longer wavelength, that is lambda max 255 nanometer to lambda max 265 nanometer, and this shifting towards the longer wavelength is called as bathochromic shift or red shift. Next term is hypsochromic shift. So in hypsochromic shift, that is a blue shift, so absorption towards the shorter wavelength, absorption towards the shorter wavelength. So hypsochromic shift or blue shift, that is shorter wavelength. So previously higher wavelength absorption, after some changes that absorbs at the lower wavelength, smaller wavelength, that is called as hypsochromic shift or blue shift. For example, aniline. So aniline shows a resonance effect, plus R effect. This amine group has a lone pair of electrons, so those electrons goes to the benzidic, and there is a plus R effect of this NH2. So it absorbs a radiation around 230 nanometer. But if you are using an acidic medium to this aniline, then what will happen? The lone pair of nitrogen will get protonated, and there is a formation of anilinium chloride. Now in this case, there is no lone pair of electrons on this nitrogen, no unshared electrons pair on this nitrogen. So delocalization of this lone pair will be not there. So resonance effect will be decreased. So lambda max also decreased, that is absorption towards the shorter wavelength. So from longer wavelength to shorter wavelength, this effect is called as hypsochromic shift or blue shift. Next term is hyperchromic shift. When the intensity of the absorption increases, that is absorbance increases, that is epsilon value increases, it is known as hyperchromic shift. So in this case, the lambda max will be same, only the increase in absorbance, height of the peak will get increased, and that is called as hyperchromic shift. The next term is hypochromic shift. When the intensity of the absorption decreases, that is absorbance decreases or epsilon value decreases, is known as hypochromic shift. So in this case also, the lambda max will be same, wavelength at which the maximum absorption will be same, but the absorbance will decrease, the epsilon value, that is molar absorptivity, will decrease, height of the peak will be smaller, and that is called as hypochromic shift. When the solvent is changed from hexane to water, then N to pi star excitations has a bathochromic shift, that is lambda max is changed from 230 nanometer to 243 nanometer. So lambda max will increase, then that is called as bathochromic shift. And the hypochromic shift, that is epsilon value, that absorption, intensity of the absorption will get decreased, that is 12,600 to 10,000 only. Whereas for it, pi to pi star transitions, there is a hypsochromic shift. So lambda max will get decreased, that is from 329 to 305 nanometer. And the hypochromic shift, that is epsilon value, get increased 43 to 60. See here in a tabular form, this is the N-hexane, that is non-polar solvent for the UV absorption, and this is the water solvent, that is polar solvent where UV absorption will be there. Now see here, if En2 pi star transition is there, En2 pi star, then in hexane, that is non-polar solvent, the lambda max is 230, while epsilon value, that is absorptivity, is 12,600. But if you increase the polarity of the solvent, then the lambda max shifts towards the longer wavelength, 230 to 243. This is called as bathochromic shift or red shift. While epsilon value, that is decreased from 12,600 to 10,000. So this decrease in epsilon value, absorptivity, is called as hypochromic shift. Similar case for pi to pi transition. So in pi to pi transitions, epsilon value in a non-polar solvent, that is 41. But if we increase the polarity, if you took this UV spectrum in a polar solvent, then absorptivity is increased. That is, absorption is increased. So this is called as hyperchromic shift. So pi to pi transitions in polar solvent shows a hyperchromic shift, while N to pi star transitions in a polar solvent shows hypochromic shift. Similar case for lambda max also. So in N to pi star, non-polar to polar, so there is a bathochromic shift, increase in lambda max. While pi to pi star transitions, previously in non-polar solvent, that is 239, that is will get decreased in polar solvent, that is 205. So that is called as hypsochromic shift. So decrease in lambda max. So now we will see in a graphical form all these terms in a one slide only. See here. So shifting of this peak towards the longer wavelength. So wavelength is increasing from left to right. So shifting of this peak towards the longer wavelength. So that is called as red shift or bathochromic shift. If shifting this peak into the lower wavelength, then that is called as hypsochromic shift or blue shift. But if the absorptivity, that is absorbance, is increases, lambda max is same, but absorption is increases, then that is called as hyperchromic shift or hyperchromic effect. If the lambda max is same, the height of the peak will decrease, absorbance is decreased, then this is called as hypochromic effect, hypochromic shift. So in this way, towards the left hand side, blue shift, towards the right hand side, red shift, upside hyperchromic shift, and lower side hypochromic shift. So in this way, these are the important terms in case of UV visible spectroscopy. Now we will see effect of conjugation on the position of UV bands. Now first example, we'll see similar chromophores, that is diene or non-conjugated alkene. So similar chromophore. Chromophore means the groups independently absorbs in a near UV region. So for example, if two double bonds are isolated by the presence of at least three single bonds, the transition takes place approximately in a same region, that is 165 to 200 nanometer. Such dienes are called as isolated dienes. For example, see here, this is ethylene molecule. So CH2 double bond, CH2, one pi bond, it absorbs at a 165 nanometer. This is 1,5-hexadiene. So diene means there are two double bonds, but these are not conjugated, these are isolated. So not conjugated double bonds are called as isolated double bonds. So those double bonds are separated by more than two single bonds from each other. Then if there are two double bonds also, the lambda max will be 165 nanometer only, because the chromophore again still double bond only. So it may that possible that absorbance will get increased, that is intensity of the peak will get increased, but the lambda max will be remains same, that is 165 nanometer. In this case, this pi to pi transitions, only one pi to pi transitions, so 165. Here is also one pi bond, two pi bonds, pi to pi transitions, intensity is increased, but lambda max will be same, because in non-conjugated system, in non-conjugated system, there is no resonance effect. So that's why these dienes are considered as alkene only. So the lambda max will be same, that is 165. In a similar manner, this is cyclohexadiene, and this is cyclohexene. So chromophore is only double bond. Here is one double bond, here are two double bonds, because those are non-conjugated, isolated double bonds, isolated dienes. So in that case, one for cyclohexadiene or cyclohexane, both are absorbing at the same wavelength, that is 165 nanometer. It may possible that these two double bonds are there, the absorption intensity will increase, epsilon value will get increased, but the lambda max will be remains same. So this is about the non-conjugated systems, diene system. It may possible that there are three or four double bonds also, but those are non-conjugated, isolated double bonds, then the absorption will be at the same wavelength, that will be 168 nanometer, or that is around 165 to 200 nanometer only. Now same case we will see, same chromophore dienes, but in a conjugated system. If two double bonds are conjugated, then absorption takes place at longer wavelength. Now chromophores are same double bonds, only system is conjugated. Conjugated means both double bonds are separated by only one single bond, alternate double single likewise. So what will happen, the conjugated absorption shifts, this conjugation shifts the absorption towards the longer wavelength, that is called as red shift. And this is because of, in a conjugated system, there is more stabilization by the resonance. If the more stabilization by the resonance, then the pi to pi star excitations of the delocalization electrons is very easier, less energetic, and hence absorption occurs at longer wavelength. When there are two carbon-carbon double bonds are separated by only single bond, such dienes are called as conjugated diene. For example, see here, this is ethylene molecule. So single chromophore, that is double bond, so it absorbs at 165 nanometer, lambda max is 165 nanometer. Similar chromophore, but in a conjugated system, that is 1,3-butadiene. Now these two double bonds are separated by only one single bond, then this system is called as conjugated diene. Now conjugated dienes absorb at longer wavelength, 220 nanometer, than the 160 nanometer in case of ethylene. So this is why, because conjugated systems having a more stabilization due to resonance. So what will happen, pi to pi star excitations of the delocalized electrons is very much easier, then less energetic, and hence absorption shifts towards the longer wavelength. The conjugation causes the bathochromic shift, red shift, that is suggests that the conjugation decreases the energy required for the excitations of the electrons. So this is because of what, the electronic excitations, pi to pi transitions, requires a less energy, and this can be explained on the basis of molecular orbital theory, that we will see in the next slide. In case of ethylene, the frequency of absorption, that is excitation energy, for the pi to pi star transitions depends upon the difference in energy between pi to pi star levels. And let us denote this is a difference, that is delta E. So in case of ethylene, the distance of pi to pi star transition is more, so wavelength will be 165. But in case of butadiene, 1,3-butadiene conjugated system, the levels comes closer, energy decreases, lambda max increases, that is 222 nanometer. From molecular orbital theory, the two atomic p orbitals from two sp2 hybrid carbon combines to form a two molecular orbitals, that is pi 1 and pi 2 star in case of ethylene. See the molecular orbital states for this ethylene molecule. So it has a two p orbitals overlapping each other. So what will happen, pi to pi star transitions, so these are the two states, ground state and electronic states, excited state in case of molecular orbital of ethylene. So this electrons, which are pi electrons, only two pi electrons having one ground state, one excited state, so by absorbing the energy, that is delta E, that electron shifts towards the pi 2 star excited state. So whatever this energy, that gives a lambda max. When we consider the butadiene, we are now mixing up 4 p orbitals, giving 4 molecular orbitals of an energetically symmetrical distribution as compared to the ethylene. So there are 4 p orbitals giving a 4 molecular orbitals, that is pi1, pi2, these are the ground state levels, and pi3 star, pi4 star are the excited state. So what will happen? These are equally distributed, symmetrical distribution. So what will happen? Now this is the highly occupied molecular orbital and this is a lower unoccupied molecular orbital. So the excitation takes place from this pi2 to pi3 transition state, pi2 to pi3 star transition state. Now this required a delta energy, a delta E2 energy. Now this is smaller than as compared to the delta E1. So if energy required is less, the lambda max shifts towards the longer wavelength. So it absorbs at longer wavelength. So this is the molecular orbital diagram for the butadiene. So what will happen? The energy for the HOMO to LIMO, that is highly occupied molecular orbital, this is higher occupied molecular orbital, to the lower unoccupied molecular orbital, this transitions, this energy will reduced in case of butadiene. So what will happen? Delta E1 is more than delta E2. As energy is inversely proportional to the lambda max, that is wavelength. So lambda max for ethylene molecule is 165 nanometer, that is less than lambda max for the butadiene, that is 220 nanometer. So what we understand here, that if the conjugation increases, then the energy required for the transition of the pi electrons from HOMO to LIMO, that energy transitions will get less, and hence the lambda max, the wavelength, shifts towards the higher wavelength. So what will happen? Just as a conjugation vadil, thus the lambda max vadat jail. Lakshat teva. Thus as a conjugation vadil, thus the energy gap kami hoil, resonance vadil, ani wavelength sudha vadil. So see the example. In extending this effect out to a longer conjugated system, the energy gap becomes progressively smaller. Say in case of ethylene, this gap is larger. Butadiene, this gap becomes smaller, smaller and smaller. So as this conjugation goes on increasing, the double bonds are in conjugation, those are goes on increasing, the energy will be less, smaller. So lower energy indicates that the longer wavelength, because energy and wavelength are inversely proportional. If the energy decreases, wavelength increases, energy increases, wavelength decreases. So in this way, as the conjugation increases, the absorption shifts towards the longer wavelength, lambda max will get increased. That is the main thing to be understood over here. Similar case in case of enon system. Now this is now different chromophore. Enon means, en means double bond, on means ketone. So when carbon-carbon double bond is in conjugation with carbonyl group, that is C double bond O, such compounds called as enons. Such compounds are called as enons. So this is carbon-carbon double bond and in conjugated with the carbonyl bond. So this particular molecule is called as crotonaldehyde. There are 4 carbons and these are the alpha beta unsaturated double bond. So this molecule is called as crotonaldehyde. So this alpha beta unsaturated ketones, carbonyl groups, those systems are called as enons. In crotonaldehyde, the olefinic chromophore is a conjugated with carbonyl group. We have seen that in a previous slide, that the isolated carbon-carbon double bond chromophore shows a pi to pi star transitions, that peak is about 165 nanometer. So isolated carbon-carbon double bond absorbs at 165 nanometer is because of pi to pi star transitions. Whereas an isolated carbonyl group, the carbonyl group chromophore shows a strong peak, is about 290 nanometer, is because of N2 pi star transitions in case of acetone. When those two chromophores are in conjugated, now this carbon-carbon double bond and carbon oxygen double bond are in conjugated as in crotonaldehyde or any typical alpha beta unsaturated system, that is called as anion. Then we have a situation somewhat similar to that of 1,3-butadiene. So the energy gap between them is decreased, same we have seen in 1,3-butadiene system. So as the conjugation increases, the pi to pi star transitions, whatever the energy required, that will get decreased, and hence the lambda max will be increased. So this is the same principle will be applied over here in case of crotonaldehyde. When this carbon-carbon double bond is in conjugation with the carbonyl group, we will see in a molecular orbital diagram or theory. Suppose this is the isolated carbon-carbon double bond. So it has only 2p orbitals. So pi to pi star transitions required a energy that is 165 nanometer wavelength. And suppose that is isolated carbonyl group. So there is a pi to pi star transitions as well as n to pi star transitions will be there. So pi to pi star transitions, it absorbs at 170 nanometer. And there is a n to pi star transitions, so it absorbs at 290 nanometer. So 290 nanometer, there is one peak, stronger peak. But if this carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-oxygen double bond put in conjugation, then there will be the alpha-beta unsaturated system. This is called as enol. Now each energy level divided into two types, and they are equally symmetrically distributed. So what will happen? There are five transition states now. Psi 1, Psi 2, An, that is non-bonding electrons, and this is Psi 3 star and Psi 4 star. So now there is a transitions from HOMO, highly occupied molecular orbital, to the LUMO, lower unoccupied molecular orbital. Now this transition energy gap is decreased as compared to this pi to pi star and as compared to this N to pi star. And because of that one, it requires a less energy as the energy gap is smaller. If it requires a less energy, the wavelength will get increased. See here, N2 pi star absorbs at 320 nanometer, while pi to pi star transitions absorbs at 218 nanometer. So this is the effect of conjugation. Thus, the conjugation decreases the energy of the excitations of the electrons, and hence increase in wavelength of absorption in UV region. The number of conjugated double bonds increases, the energy required for pi to pi star transitions or excitations decreases, and hence lambda max will get increases. So in short, as the conjugation increases, lambda max is increases. Thank you friends. In next video, we will learn Woodward-Fizer rule and solving the UV visible spectroscopic problems. Thank you once again.